Morning, everyone. I'm Darrell Steinberg, the mayor of Sacramento. I'm joined here by a number of my colleagues, Vice Mayor of the City of Sacramento, Angelique Ashby, Council Members Jay Chenier, Rick Jennings, and Councilmember Katie Valenzuela, in whose district, of course, this awful event occurred. A couple of initial announcements before I make a statement. Number one, we're asking everybody to please give some space to the families. We're setting up a place of refuge and support at City Hall, which is why we're doing this event here. Secondly, the police department's Twitter and all our Twitter pages will have the QR that will allow anybody who has any information about who perpetrated this awful crime this morning to be able to report, and to report quickly, so that the police can investigate and arrest those responsible and hold them accountable. I want to thank my colleagues. I want to thank the police department for their tireless work. And I also want to thank the community-based organizations who have been up since the middle of the night working to try to provide support and solace wherever they can. They always do that, and we're deeply appreciative. This morning, our city has a broken heart. This is a senseless and unacceptable tragedy, and I emphasize the word unacceptable. Thoughts and prayers, of course, are appropriate for the victims and their families and the people who are still, who are fighting for their lives now in the hospital. But thoughts and prayers are not nearly enough. We must do more as a city, as a state, and as a nation. This senseless epidemic of gun violence must be addressed. How many unending tragedies does it take before we begin to cure the sickness in this country? Let us be honest, this is a sickness. The fact that we accept the idea that people can have ready access to assault weapons, to weapons of destruction, and can indiscriminately use them however and wherever they want, that is not just an exception. It happens far too often. It is a sickness in our culture, and we must do everything we can to heal that sickness. We do not know the facts, and we're not here actually to comment on the investigation. That's the role of the Sacramento Police Department. And we will await, you know, their press availability, I'm sure sometime in the next couple of hours, to update you. And so we don't know whether or not this involved underage perpetrators or even the victims at this point. But regardless, it's another call to action around investing more in youth and prevention and early intervention for our young people. That's ultimately the answer to so much of what plagues us. And then on the public safety side, to the public, people are understandably worried. Who wouldn't be? This has been a very difficult time in downtown Sacramento and in Sacramento as a whole. And certainly what happened last night gives pause to our entire community. But be reassured that no one can absolutely prevent random acts of violence. Nobody can predict or absolutely prevent random acts of violence, but your city is protected by dedicated and committed law enforcement officials, by committed public officials who are standing behind me, an entire city team, and unending tangible support, again, from community-based organizations and the community. Like we always do, we will get through this, we will rally, and we will be better for it. This is a time for strength. It is a time for reflection. It is a time to check ourselves. It is a time to up the quotient of kindness and caring for one another. It's time for healing, and it's time for action.